Hi guys, and welcome back to Elite Dangerous. Now, I have to admit, I haven't played this for a few days, and we totally failed the boom data delivery. It's kind of not my fault. I was busy working, and the missions are timed, so I couldn't do the mission in time, and my pad broke. But I managed to get a pad again, so we have to discard these missions, unfortunately. So the progress we are made, or trying to make, is going to be very slow. Anyway, let's go into the starport services. We're at the Salpeter Enterprise. So let's look at some missions. We need to do a mission, man. Okay, what do we have? Two units of grain. Maybe we can do this one. Gore's platform. Okay, we'll do this one. We can transport some grain. It's not a problem. Right. Let's open the galaxy map and plot our course. We are going to the Hercules system, is it? I'm pretty sure it's this system here. Okay. So we've plotted our route. And, let's have a... Oh, system map unavailable. Okay, we can buy the system map for like a grand, but I'm not going to bother. So let's launch. Let's hope we don't have any disasters leaving the station like we did before. That was embarrassing. I'm pretty sure it was a federal dropship and not the liner, but either way, it was still pretty funny. Right, here we go.
Detach confirmed that you are clear to leave.
We have a commander in the area also. Okay, let's leave the station.
Landing gear retracted.
And we'll hit the boost to get away from the station as quickly as possible. Right, okay, so we've got to go through Markov's point. Being the first stop. It's kind of interesting news on the Elite Dangerous front. Alien ships. I haven't encountered any. With this piece of shit, I don't think an alien will be interested in visiting me. But there have been alien encounters. So it's going to be very interesting to see how that plays out in the future, you know. I mean, these ships look badass. They look like these big flowers. But, you know, the technology that these guys have... I'm not saying Thargoids. Maybe Thargoids, or maybe, you know... Maybe it's just... tip of the iceberg of what's going to be happening in Elite Dangerous. I'm just a lonely commander with not much money, and that's a big ass brown dwarf. Well, let's get out of its gravitational well, and we might as well scan it and get some extra cash. It looks like it's just a one sun system. You know, scanning the brown dwarf is not too bad. Well, we need to go to this destination. Now, you watch my temperature go through the freaking roof. When there's a brown dwarf star, I don't know what it is. But my temperature just skyrockets. Hercules. I don't know the pronunciations of some of these systems. If I get interdicted by like a freaking alien me, I'd be well happy, but it's not going to happen. It really isn't. I mean, what are the chances? And I think you need to have specific parts on your ship, like the unknown, like unknown artifact or something? I don't know. Like I said, I'm totally not an elite pro. Might as well quickly scan the sun while I'm here. 6 objects. And there we have it, guys. We need to go to the Gores platform, so we'll lock onto this destination. It's not too far away, only 181 LS. So let's make our way over to the Gores platform. Have a quick little gander at the system map. Okay, so two star system. These planets are pretty cool. They're like lava based worlds. And this is where we're heading, to the Gores platform. Oh shit! Right, we need to slow down. Okay, there we go. We're still coming in a little bit too quick. Okay, there we go. We've got a sensible speed. We're going to get a £10,000. I remember on the last part, we actually dropped money on the frameshift drive because I couldn't plot any routes. Shall I just explore this planet? Might as well, while we're in range. I mean, cash is cash at the end of the day. I mean, can't turn your nose up at that. There we go. No, I don't want to lock on the. There we go. We need to go to Gore's platform. Coming in to drop in range shortly. Speed's looking good. Distance nominal. Right. It's telling me to slow down, but we're good. We don't have to worry about overshooting. What the hell? Two minutes to land and we'll get a little bonus. Right, okay, we need to request docking at 7.5 km. Landing pad 2. Let's get a bit of a boost. Like I said, my landing is not brilliant. My landing skills and docking skills are not fantastic on this game. Is that platform number 2 here? Yep, that's platform number 2, so we need to kind of slow this baby down. Landing gear, please. Are the lights off? There we go. Landing gear deployed. Oh shit, I came in the wrong way. That is savage. God damn it. Oh shit, I think I hit something. Here we go. Right. Hopefully now all should be good. Let's tip the nose up a little bit. There we go. Right, straight into the services. Cash in the reward and hopefully we shall get some type of reward. There we go. Sterling work, Commander. I'd happily work with you again. They've reduced the chances of famine on them two two lots of grain. Right, let's see if we have any other. We've got another boom delivery here in the Ross system. Yeah, might as well take it. I mean, why the hell not? Yeah, we need to go into the services. We need to refuel. Okay. To the next mission. Okay, Ross 730. We'll plot a route there. You know, that delivery went pretty smooth. No one wanted our blood. So I can't complain too much. What's this guy saying? Promotion to mostly penniless. Well done, Commander, on your first trade rank. Oh, thanks. We're now mostly penniless. And to be fair, we are pretty penniless. Maybe I should actually attempt some of the missions on the planet, maybe, to get a bit more cash. But my confidence isn't thrilling. I mean, I've played with the SUV thing a little bit, but my driving skills are probably not up to par yet. Plus, it's like a different mechanic when you use your radar, and you know you gotta call your ship down. We'll see what goes on. Okay then, another unknown star, is it? Yep, another unknown star. Single star system by the looks of things. Wow, we actually need a permit to go to Vega. Also special about Vega. Interesting. What the hell? Okay, time for the second jump to Ross 730. Man, it's fucking quiet in this system, man. It's kind of weird. I guess it's, you know, because there's only just a sun. A couple of suns in the system. It's not very well populated. Ross 730 should offer some more interesting things. Okay, and just about see the sun. Yep, here we come. We're coming in now. Yes! Let's do this. More money. It's all about the money. Oh, great. More critical messages. What? We've had that. 3 minutes. Jeez, we gotta get. Ain't got time to explore you, fam. We gotta get Pavlov settlement. Let's go. Right, we don't have a fuel scoop, but we have 3 minutes to get the job done. Oh shit! It's actually pretty close. Like, really close to the sun. Three minutes, man. Am I going to do this in time? Oh, shit, it's a planetary landing, I think. Really? It can't be. Slow the fuck down, slow down, slow down. No, it's just... on orbit of this dust ball. Okay, speed's looking good. Come on, let me drop in. Okay, here we go. Alright, let's have a request on docking. Speed up a little bit. Okay, landing pad 2. Where are you? Landing pad 2. Is it underneath? Where's landing pad 2? Oh my god. Is on the other side. I don't know where it is, guys. Aha, there it is. And we're actually... Come on, let's dock up. Whoa. Okay, we're smelling good. Right, straight into the services. Cash in the mission and get another bonus, hopefully. Excellent. Okay. We're getting a bit of cash now. We're up to 82,000. Anything to do from this system? Another boom data, but it's only 7 grand. And it's 14 light years away as well. I'm gonna do it anyway. Why the hell not? Well, let's accept. Refuel. Cost pennies to refuel because my tank and this, actually, can we actually sell some of our shit? The universal cartoc. Yes, we can. We can sell some stuff. We'll get another £12,000 because we're over 20 light years away. This is for like scanning the planets and other anomalies in space. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna launch and fly to our next destination, and then by the next part, we'll hopefully have a new ship. And that looks sick. I mean, look at that. Is that... What the hell is that? It's got like school pirates around it. That's pretty cool. Right. Destination. Okay, let's plot our course. Shit! It won't let us. Too far away. Where the hell are we? We're here. Can we make it? Kind of sucks that. Okay, so maybe we... Maybe we can jump to this system here, stock up on a bit of fuel, and be on our merry way. It's kind of a bit... It's a bit annoying. Because the jump on this thing's so awful. Didn't we plot a course? Right, here we go. I was going to do a couple of jumps to these few systems, and then hopefully it'll bring us a slightly bit closer so we can get to where we need to go. Four, three, two, one, engage. God, I find this game so therapeutic. I don't know what it is. It's like, to some people it might be boring. I can understand that. But to me, it's just so chill. Right, okay, we need to get past this sun. Because our destination is just slightly over it. Okay, we're good. I'm going to wait till the temperature drops a little bit. There we go. Midgecut? I don't know. Midgecut. Okay, we're going to Midgecut, guys. It's an unknown system to us, but I can guarantee someone else has already explored it. Okay. See, aliens don't care about me. They don't care. Right, slow the hell down. Man, there's a lot of stars in this system. And that's very far out. God damn it, that's really far out. Jeez. Let's go back to the galaxy map. Our mission is, I think it's here. That's where we need to go. Now, have I got enough juice in the tank to take me here? It could be just a dead system because... It could be just a dead system because there's absolutely nothing... I can't even purchase any data, so I'm thinking it's a dead system. So what I'll probably have to do... is yeah, it's way too far out. Can I plot a route here? No. The Lightspeed accommodation hotel chain has its flagship hotel in the system. Can we get to Haghole? No fucking chance. No way. Okay, guys, so how many light years is that? 9.72. Interesting. No, I'm just gonna have to do the long haul, guys. It's going to have to be done. It's going to take some time. There's actually people in this area. Okay, let's get our asses over to this dock. And fucking pray we have enough juice to get us to where we need to go for our next mission. To hand it in anyway. This is going to take some freaking time. Okay, so let's have a look at some of our stuff. A Federation rank, 3%. We have engineers as well. We haven't even started on the engineers yet, which is crazy. Fire groups, inventory... Yeah, so what can I say, guys? We basically got nothing. Okay, let's have a little look at the old galaxy map, shall we? Okay, there's a lot of stuff cracking off in Colonia. All sorts of I don't know what the hell's going on down here. I think it's a community goal or something. And let's have a look where we are. Okay, so we're quite close to home, actually. We're close to Sol. On the original Frontier, I used to do this Bernard Star run to Ross, I think it was Ross 154, and used to load up on computers and stuff and anything to try and get money, and I grinded for hours until I got to where I got like an Asp Explorer on Frontier Elite 2, and that was when I was at uni, you know, burning time on Elite. But yeah, man, those were the days, and I just kind of stopped playing. And Elite Dangerous came out and kind of changed my life in a little bit, you know. It just, like I said, it's a very relaxing game. I guess, oh shit, we're getting closer. Yeah, it is quite relaxing. You know, I know it's like some people play like Euro Truck Simulator and get that same type of satisfaction. Or like Farming Simulator or things like that. And what the hell is going on up here? I don't risk it to find out. There's an unidentified signal source, which I don't want to check out, because someone's going to be kicking my ass. This Sidewinder ain't equipped for combat. Okay, we're nearly there. Not too far away. Metcalf Dock. I really want to get my ass inside one of these starports, man. I'm getting fed up with these docks. Yeah, I'm getting impatient. Oh shit, we're coming in way too quick. Okay. There's actually a planet there. I just managed to see it now. It's so dark. Right. Let's get a bit closer. We're nearly there. Some weird type of moon. Okay. Let's fuel up and hope. Okay, pad one. Where are you? Let the struggle commence. Where are you, pad one? Is that it? Yep, here she is. Pad one. Are we on the wrong side again? And the answer to that question is... absolutely we're on the wrong side again. God damn it. Where are we up? There we go.
Landing gear deployed. Docking successful.
Rightio, let's fuel up. See if we can plot our route. Come on. Come on, we can do this, right? Fuck. Can we go here? Nope. Hack hole. Come on. No. It's not happening, guys. Okay, well, I'll probably do it because we've got quite a bit of cash. We've got nearly 100,000. Can we, trade in any bonds? No, we can't. Okay, I'm going to sack off these missions. And we're going to cut the recording here. I don't think we'll have any consequences for abandoning that. We do have that fine where we had the head-on collision. Oh well. Anyway, guys, until next time. Peace. I hope you enjoyed watching. See you guys.